Now, the governing National Resistance Movement says it's moving to bar members of parliament of the leaning to the party from moving private members' bills before the floor of parliament. According to the government chief whip, Thomas Taiba, these members will now be required to submit their proposals to the caucus, and then the proposals shall be submitted to government bills to avoid what he described as embarrassing situations. Mr. Taiba made the plea while speaking at the inauguration of the parliamentary caucus earlier today.
So Brandon, that is your file, read it, understand everything you need, follow the communication channels of the NRM, and may God bless you.
Last week, the NRM parliamentary caucus sitting in Kololo elected its leadership. Today, the new leadership was inaugurated by the government chief whip, Thomas Taiba. While officiating at the handover ceremony, Taiba disclosed a plan to neutralize NRM MPs from moving private members' bills before the floor.
We are going to be working with our colleagues, chairpersons, and our members wherever they are. According to our rules of procedure, a bill should be processed within 45 days. Some of them, of course, are unrealistic. But this business of having bills spend a whole year or 2 years without being processed by Parliament, that has to stop, especially government bills. We are going to be encouraging members to mainly bring their issues to the party.
Taiba committed to engage all MPs who have interests to move private bills to ensure they surrender their legislative proposals to government to be incorporated into government bills to avoid clashes, which at times embarrasses government.
You share your ideas. You don't be selfish to say, I'm having this idea. I want to go on record that I'm the one who introduced a private member's bill. No, come. These are opinions. Bring them to the family. We share and We adopt them as government. We present them to government as a caucus, and we say we feel this is very important.
The chief whip also tasked NRM MPs to get social media accounts to enhance smooth communication from the caucus.
The NRM member has a social media account. We can agree on main ones. We can agree on Facebook. We agree on Twitter. Even Instagram, the young people, we need them, you know. We need them. So that we make it very, very easy. Each one of us should come out and publicize, especially parliamentary resolution. We don't want to be depending on someone else's mercy to give us publicity on that.
The former NRM caucus spokesperson, Margaret Muhangi, also challenged the new NRM caucus leadership led by the vice chairperson, Herbert Chinobere, to make use of social media to publicize NRM achievements.
Each one of you has got a duty. Do not be visible here among 336 members of parliament. Be visible in the whole world. This world has become a small global village. You don't have to go on Instagram. Those ones are for younger people, maybe people who are too social media addicts. But go to things like Facebook. There are so many Ugandans on it. Go to Twitter. Post things, good things about NRM. NRM has totally no one who speaks for it.
The caucus leadership has also been tipped to crack down on groups within party members, which arose from the speakership elections, hence discouraging unity and consensus.
Hearing so many stories, this was so-and-so's camp. When did the camps begin? I've been talking to this man.
Yes.
What I liked about him after the election?
Yes.
The man said, man, you guys defeated us. And I asked him, didn't you see it coming? It ended there. We became friends again.
Yes.
We called each other. We speak about many things.
Yes.
It was just a vote which ended. Nobody should follow the other just because I won this. This one must get out of my office. It will bring you just opening new fronts for you to fight.
NRM has 339 MPs in parliament who compose the party caucus. Story by Fred Kajubi for the news in parliament.